When two bodies interact, creating push or pull, this push or pull is called force. Force is a quantity that is felt as either as push or pull when two bodies interact. Hitting, kicking, running, jumping, these are all examples of force. Forces are of two types, contact forces and non-contact forces. For one body to apply force on the other body, contact is required. Suppose we want to push or pull a weight. A weight has a force down. This force is because of the gravitation of the earth. It is the weight. To uplift the body, we have to exert muscular force. What is a muscular force? Muscular force is the force developed in muscles to act on a body. These are contact forces. What is the force of friction? When two bodies with their surface in contact slide, that is, move in relative motion with surface in contact, a force of friction is generated because of the relative motion. This force of friction is always in the opposite direction to the moving body. Suppose one body is stationary, the other body with its surface in contact slides in one direction, the force produced by the friction will be in opposite direction. When two bodies with their surfaces in contact slide in relative motion, then a force of friction is generated between them. This force of friction is always against the net relative velocity of the bodies. If the velocity changes, the force immediately, force of friction immediately changes its direction. Suppose you, what are contact forces? Suppose you want to push a sandbag. We have to hit it. But with the fish at a distance, we cannot push the sandbag. There requires contact with the bag. So this hitting force of the fish of the human hand is a contact force. What is the gravitational force? Gravitational force is the force of attraction on between two bodies. Any two bodies, because of their mass, always create attractive force. This is the fundamental property of mass, material. The earth attracts all materials towards itself. But not only the earth. Any two materials have the force of attraction between them because of their mass. Suppose there is a heavy lead ball and a small wooden ball kept near to it. That golden ball will be attracted towards big heavy big ball and the earth attracts all the objects. So the force of attraction between any two bodies because of their masses is called force of gravity or gravitational force. This force is very big, and if the body is large enough, then and only then it is felt in appreciable amount. For small bodies, this force is just negligible. What is the magnetic force? When two magnets are kept brought near to each other, and if their poles are same, they will create a repelling force, and if their poles are opposite, they will create an attractive force. So magnetic force is of two types, attractive or repelling. Suppose north pole of one magnet is brought to the north pole of another magnet, both of them will be repelled because of magnetism. North pole of one magnet, if brought near to south pole of another magnet, it will be attracted because of their magnetism. Thus, magnetic force, because of magnetism, is also possessed by several bodies. Now, magnetic force can act at a distance. There is no need of any contact for the magnetic force to act. So, magnetic forces are different from contact forces. Magnetic forces are non-contact forces. They are of two types, attractive or repulsive, whereas gravitational force is also only of one type, that is attractive type. Muscular force, now you will be surprised that our body muscles or muscles of any animals always can always generate attractive force, not repulsive force. So muscular force is always because of biological structure of attractive type. Suppose we have to uplift that the front muscle of the hand will contract, because we have to press, then the hind muscle, backside muscle of the hand will contract. So for two directions, there is a need of two muscles for the organ or movement. So muscular force is only of attractive type. Muscles cannot produce repulsive force. This is the biological property of muscles. Now, what are electrostatic force? All these materials are made up of matter. All matters possess charge, electric charge. But because the charges are of two types, being opposite to each other, most of the bodies having two charges in equal amount exist as a result chargeless bodies. But by some measure, if the equal amount is disturbed, suppose by rubbing, some charge of the body is removed, then the body becomes electrically charged. Now, electrically charged body, like magnets, will either attract or repel. another charge body. If the charges are like, then there will be a repulsion. If the charges are opposite, then there will be an attraction. As there are two types of magnetism, magnetic poles we say, north pole and south pole, there are two types of charges, plus charge and minus charge. This plus and minus has nothing to do with mathematics. Plus charge is of one type, minus charge is of exactly of another, opposite type. So it is better to say that similar charges attract, no, they repel, and dissimilar charges attract. Plus charge will attract another plus charge, and plus charge will attract another minus charge, negative charge, and plus charge will repel another similar plus charge. Now, when a cloth is rubbed in hair, some electric charge is ripped off the cloth. The remaining form becomes electrically charged. If some paper pieces are kept near the comb will attract those paper pieces because there exists some charge on them. If there is an opposite charge present on the paper pieces, they will be attracted. So, electric forces or magnetic forces or gravitational forces do not need contact to act. Suppose there is a spring fixed at the ceiling and a load is hanging. And suppose we want to bring down the load, we have to handle it and drag down. This is a contact force. But the earth attracts without contraction, contact. Earth force, because of gravitation of earth, does not require any contact. So it is a non-contact force. Electrical forces, magnetic forces, gravitational forces are of non-contact type of forces. What is meant by pressure? Pressure is force per unit area, provided the force acts normally. Or if we consider only the normal effective force, then force per unit area is called pressure. Force has direction as well as magnitude. Force can act in a special direction, fixed direction. It has a specific magnitude. Force may be small or big. So, force is expressed in two ways. Both these are necessary to describe the force completely. One, the direction of the force, the other, magnitude of the force. But pressure does not need to describe completely its direction. Dear students, try to solve these questions. What is meant by pressure? Pressure is the force per unit area. Short answer. The remaining we shall discuss. Thank you.